that? Is this more to do with possible post-pole alliances than anything else?
I won't look at it like this. I think Mr. Farooqi has amply answered your question by saying that the Samaj Party party chief, Mr. Mulayam Singh Yadav, has already said that this is not a third front. This is an anti-communalism conclave. And that is what we heard the NCP spokesperson, Mr. Praful Patel, say just now. So please look at it from the prism of coming together of parties with similar ideas and ensuring that the ethos of India and the secular India
except
is preserved.
Except that those are ideas that you claim to share and you weren't there. That's my point. You were deliberately not invited. So Siddharth Nath Singh, how does the BJP look at it? Does it look at it dismissively as an anti-Modi front and the whole attempt to cobble together a third front? Do you see it like that or do you laugh it off?
It's a coalition of diminishing returns of political parties who are traditionally secular fundamentalist. Another message with this coming together of these parties on a forum together is for the Congress and Rahul Gandhi that they have lost faith in Congress and in Rahul Gandhi. Indirectly they are saying because you are unable to match or fight or challenge Narendra Modi and BJP, so you get a side. We are here to challenge and fight BJP and Narendra Modi. Now the problem is whatever Rahul Gandhi and Congress were saying, they wanted as a strategy to have a debate on communalism, secularism, which they have failed. They are the new whatever coalition they may call, or I may call them the B team of Congress. They all have got together again, and their plank is what to the nation? Communalism should be stopped, secularism, communalism fight. None of them are talking about what the nation wants or what they wish to hear, which is how do you fight corruption, how do you fight inflation, how do you increase employment in this country. And surprisingly, the people who are sitting on that forum, Nidhi, there are people like Samajwadi Party who have been, their minister has been caught in a sting operation creating a Muzaffar Nagar riots. Everybody is aware of it, but none of them are talking about it. So they are soft on terror, they are themselves involved in communalism, they are not able to bring development in their state.
So the one factor that seems to be bringing them together is that they are anti-Narendra Modi. And when you look at a post-poll scenario,
fair enough,
possible
that shows,
alliances,
that shows,
doesn't
Nidhi,
that worry you?
I'm happy. No, certainly not. Nidhi, I'm happy. It shows the strength and the popularity of Narendra Modi and BJP, which is scared already. Congress, they are out of the scene. Now it is the 17 parties to get together. Few of them will leave anyway. But they have all come together because they want to challenge one man whose popularity is unmatched now in India. That is Narendra Modi. So I am very happy. Let them. It's a targeted Narendra Modi.
Okay, I'm going to get them to respond to that.
That is the fight which we wanted.
Okay, I'll ask the parties to respond to that. But let me get Mr. Bhushan's analysis of this. How do you look at it? And, you know, Siddharth Nath Singh made a good point that some of these parties eventually may not stick to this so-called anti-Modi front or whatever it may be. You don't know what exactly Jayalalitha will do. It's very interesting, the game that she's been playing. But you don't know where she'll be at the end of the day. There are uncertainties about the BJD. All of this could change depending on the arithmetic at the end of the day.
So, I think any front that is formed will be after the elections.
Exactly.
That's for sure. I also don't believe that Jayalalitha and Mr. Naveen Patnaik would go with BJP.
Why?
But it depends upon the numbers. If BJP gets 200 seats, Jayalalitha is going there or Naveen Patnaik is going there is not going to help them. Remember that the 13-day government of Atal Bihari Vajpayee fell for want of one seat, and Atal Bihari Vajpayee was an inclusive personality, and here you have an extremely polarizing, divisive person. So I don't think that after election Jayalalitha or Naveen Patnaik will go with BJP. But all these parties are looking beyond 2014. Communalism is a platform that is that will bind them together. That is anti-communalism, their opposition to Modi. It's an anti-BJP, anti-Congress platform that is being set up, and it is being set up by the left because the left is under no compulsion to support the Congress. They have already burnt their fingers with the Congress in 2008, and they will certainly not support the BJP. So it's an attempt to get like-minded parties, tell them about what's happening in the country, and what's happening in the country is dangerous. Mr. Modi is a polarizing factor, but it's not only an anti-Modi platform. If Mr. Modi was not there, this platform still would be there. It's an anti-BJP platform also. So,
you think the BJP should worry about this development?
They should worry, and because the calculation of these parties is that neither the BJP nor the Congress may be in a position to form the government after the 2014 elections, and they're preparing for that. Today it's a platform, anti-communalism platform, but their eyes are in the post-poll scenario. They're looking at the post-poll scenario.
Okay, Kamal Farooqi.
I personally feel that philosophically, all those people who are there today, and some of the parties who are not even joined, but they are definitely very clear as far as the secularism is concerned. The one binding force to them is the anti-communalism. And to me, it is very satisfying. Because all those people who have joined together, under no circumstances, it seems that they will be joining hands with Modi. That is one thing is sure. So if that thing is ensured, rest of the thing could be discussed.
Can you be absolutely certain of that? I mean, Mr. Bhushan is feels
that's
that
what I'm saying,
the
that
BJD and Jayalalitha will not go with Mr. Modi.
But what if
the numbers are different tomorrow?
No, in any case, at least these people, they have one common thread among themselves, that they are anti-communalism. And that is a...
But Randeep Surjewala, the criticism that Siddharthnath Singh has made of the Congress then is that if this is indeed an anti-communalism platform, which I asked you at the beginning, then the Congress is conspicuous by not being there and not being part of that. What is the message that these parties are sending you today?
Nidhi, the difference really lies in our approach and theirs. Why is Bharatiya Janata Party so worried and jittery about the Congress? We are very confident as to what our credentials are. The truth is, there is the RSS ideology, which is a polarizing ideology in this country, and there are people on both sides of the fence. The left parties have worked with the Congress in the past. Most of these parties, and some of them, Samajwadi Party even today is an ally of the Congress. In the UPA, that is how we run the government today. And NCP is a very valued ally also, like the Samajwadi Party. Why do you think we cannot work together post this election again if there is a need? All that I'm saying is, the debate really is not of a third front at all, because that third front or any front is yet to be formed. All the leaders have dismissed who already participated in this today itself. Talk of a third front. The debate is, there are polarizing ideologies in this country, and there are political parties, irrespective of minor differences that they have in the states, who stand on one side. And Congress has always led that secular debate in the country.
So you're saying it's Modi versus the rest. Is that what this election has come down to, Mr. Bhushan? Modi versus the rest?
Can I just add one more line and say, it is not Mr. Narendra Modi. That is something that BJP is seeking to project. It is the RSS divisive ideology that any number of individuals